really kidding. I need like an up light here. Use your cell phone. Yeah. Oh. How's that?
Yeah. I might leave that on.
These influencers, I think they're onto something here.
I know. Welcome to Talk Tennis. The playtesters are here, or at least some of them. And we are going to have a deep dive into playtester picks. Welcome, Chris, Jason, Brittany. Woo! You guys, it's like super exciting because, like I said earlier, I think today is the first time we all were in the office together, like our whole little crew.
Crew is back.
Crew is back. So some of our diehard fans and longtime listeners and people who watch our reviews will notice that Britt has been absent. She's now back after having a baby, delivering a baby, girl. So we're so excited that your family is growing. I never know what to say because I don't know how transparent you want to be. And I'm like,
that's fine.
You and James.
Family is growing. That works.
We have future play testers.
Yes.
We're starting them early.
Awesome. And Britt is back and we're happy to have her back. It was Woo! Quiet and a lack of organization.
You guys missed all my emails and reminders. I know Chris did, especially.
I didn't get anything done the last couple of months. Britt was out. Any reminders to remind me to do it.
But so this episode is going to be completely dedicated to current playtester picks, what everyone's using, their gear of choice. We have been hitting a bunch of stuff in the past year. There's so much more coming out towards the end of the year. I'd say a lot more stuff coming out the second half of this year.
So much more.
Yeah. So maybe we'll give you a few sneak peeks into some items that we've already seen and been able to hit with and that we can talk about. But let's start with the big name items. Current racket of choice. Give me your current racket of choice and then like your second. Like what's the backup in case it's a bad day and nothing's really working? So Chris, we can start with you.
So my racket of choice is still the Technofiber TF40 305. And if I'm having a bad day and it's not working, I go to my bag and I get out another Technically, yeah, 4305, probably with a different string in it. But I'll just be blaming the string at that point. I also hit the head speed pro a lot. So I've got one of those, super easy for me to transition between those two rackets. It goes at both 18-20. So launch angle is pretty similar. I get really similar levels of control and feel on the ball out of both rackets. So those are probably my two favorite rackets right now. And I do use the speed as well for a lot of string playtesting, just because I really like that racket as well.
Is your racket stock?
My racket has a leather grip. So it's a little heavier than stock just because the leather is a little heavier. And then when I was playing two-handed, you know, I did have some lead tape at the hoop, but when I went back to a 20, I took that off.
That's what I was going to say is like, if it's a really, really bad day, he'll go in the bag and find an extended racket and start hitting double handed on both sides. Okay, Jason, your turn. What is the go-to right now?
Go-to currently is the Prince Twist Power X100, but I have it modified just a little bit heavier. And I try not to mess with the swing weight too much because I like it low. So that's my current racket of choice, but there are a few that I really enjoy. So like, just like the Twist, same family, Twist Power X97 Tour. That's kind of the weight I like it at, but I like a little bit larger head size. So that's a little sneak peek of what's coming. Probably, I think Britt's going to mention it. and then another racket that I love, because my previous racket of choice was the Clash, is the new Clash 100S. So way back in the day, I used to love the Steam 99S. And so this is kind of a blend of kind of the two rackets I love. Lots of spin, that Clash feel, easy maneuverability, power, spin. So
what's the string pattern on that one? There it is. For all those watching.
It is an 1816.
Okay.
So not as extreme as the old Steam 99S. That one was insanely open. And that one I couldn't use as a my racket of choice because it broke strings every time I went out there. So this one's a little bit tighter, but very open still.
Brittany, you are back. You're back on the court. I think when you were just leaving us, the E-Zones had launched, and I know you previously have been a big fan of those rackets, and I think you like this update, but what's the current racket of choice?
Well, it is the E-Zone, but the actual E-Zone launched last year, so I think it was the V-Core is your...
You're right.
Out.
And I'm just like, what is last year?
Yeah, that's true. So it was 6 months of me not playing tennis, which has probably been the longest I've ever not played tennis in my life since I was like 7 or 8. So obviously I went back to old trusty, the E-Zone 100, which I've used at least 3 or 4 generations of the E-Zone 100, starting back at the AI, which I know Jay at one point used too. So, you know, it's just that racket I always pick up if I'm not feeling good. It's always my one I love. And it's just easy power, easy spin and maneuverability. And I still have a little bit of control, especially right now when I'm shanking a little bit or mishitting. It's helping me get my timing back.
Michelle, you didn't tell us yours.
Oh, well, I was going to ask Brett if she has a second potential. I know she always likes she's like the new Pure Drive also, and she's now starting to hit with more of the new Prince rackets that have come out.
Yeah, so the last couple of weeks, I've been back. I've been trying to get every racket that's come out or is about to come out, trying to get at least 1 or 2 hits in. And right before I went on maternity leave, I got to hit with the Twist Power X100 Tour, which will be coming out later this year. And I absolutely fell in love with it. Swing weight is just on this particular racket right here. It was a couple points too high for me. So I'm hoping maybe I can find one in our batch that's a couple points lower. But I've been a Prince fan in juniors and in college. So I can always go and pick up a Prince 100 square inch racket and enjoy it. So this one's been really fun, and I'm going to get strung up again so I can hit more with it.
Nice.
Awesome. We're going to be fighting over that one.
Yeah. Uh-oh.
You find your own racket. You stay with the lighter one.
She's just going to hide it or just like, yeah, disguise it or something. Put something on it so you won't know.
I'd say play for it, but you still won't get it, Jay.
Oh
yeah, I don't like that. That's not even.
Dear Prince, can we get some more samples of rackets to save this relationship?
Maybe like a his and hers. Like I choose a different color. Oh. Not that I don't like black, but
I like that idea. Get like the writing in a different color, maybe.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you?
And me. Well. Me and my commitment issues. I cannot leave the RF97, which is like the opposite of a commitment issue. I'm like too scared. No, I mean, why leave a good thing? I guess that's the real answer. So Wilson,
but Roger says
RF97. I have like 4 in my bag. I've been doing a bunch of play tests with strings and been using those tried and true RF97s. Without being too obvious about quality control, they're not all at the same spec. So it really does kind of depend on the way I'm feeling, depends on which one I'm hitting the best, but they all definitely range in different swing weights. So they all kind of offer me a little bit of something different, which I actually like having in my bag. So if I'm feeling strong, I'll go towards the heavier side of the swing weight. But if not, I kind of gravitate towards the lower end. A close second for me right now is still going to be like the Pure Drive Tour. I added a little bit of weight to the tip of the one that I have in my bag. So just love that Pure Drive feel. I can't quit the Pure Drive.
Pure Drives and Pro Staffs.
I mean, it's all good. We're here for it. Should we talk about string?
Oh, I got an honorable mention racket.
Oh, please.
Yeah. Got it right here.
Oh,
so okay. This is the 2021 Radical MP, and I do get out. There's a string we've been testing. It's not a poly. And so I picked up this one, and then I'll put a multi in here, a poly in here. It's a really versatile racket, so I can use it with any of those. Really clean, crisp feel from this racket. So I had a really good time with it. So much so on the playtest that I'm not ready to just you know, let it hang on the wall. So I still like to take this one out and hit with it, play singles or doubles. It's one of those rackets where from all areas of the court, take a shot if you're playing the teed up drinking game. this is a good racket. And I can volley well with it. I serve well with it. It feels great on my groundies and returns. So good job, Head. That's a good racket.
Would you say that one's right in your wheelhouse?
It's in my wheelhouse, Jay.
Okay, we should have started this episode with like a key too. Can you hit from all areas of the court? Yes, we hear you guys when you tell us you love our catchphrases. So
I didn't even talk about his plow through, but you know, that's, we'll get to that another day.
Serving up pancakes.
Scalpel-like.
Any other honorable mentions? Like something that you have in your bag that's fun to grab. I like a Friday hit where like I don't have to be playtesting anything but exactly what I want to be playtesting. So for that, do you guys have? So the other day, it might have been one of our doubles matches, Chris.
It was Friday. You played Pure Drive with Kevlar in it.
The Prince Pro Blend. But then I also have an old Pure Drive plus the GT one, bright blue Smurf color. Mm-hmm. I pulled that out. I think, it was on the Jet Mach 2 review because I was trying to go Babolat. Yes. So that one's always in my bag.
That is a good one.
Yeah.
I'll piggyback you. I always have a Pure Drive, either Pure Drive or Pure Drive VS, depending how I'm feeling. I do like that Pure Drive VS, but Pure Drive is a guilty pleasure for sure.
Jay, any honorable mentions?
The Prince Vortex is actually really nice. It just easy. It's like Pure Drive like. It's like easy power. It's just easy to swing, and it's been fun. That's what I've been hitting a lot lately.
Nice. I love the paint job on that racket too.
And, old school vibes.
Yeah,
that launches. I don't know when we're posting this podcast, but that launches hopefully mid July.
So soon.
So sneak peek, but soon. And we are place testing that one. And the heavier, you said the 300 you like, Jay?
Yeah, I like the 300.
And there'll be a 310 version as well.
Sweet.
Check those out.
What about strings? I feel like there's been a lot of strings. I know Chris has been testing strings like crazy lately and like everything, not just polys. You've been trying a little bit of everything, hybrids, multis, all of the things. Do you have anything that comes to mind right now that is your go-to and any honorable mentions?
So many things that come to mind and I can't talk about any of them.
Dang it.
They're all next year releases or later this year. So there's some really cool strings, some strings I'm really loving that I would be happy to go and play a tournament with, but I can't talk about them.
Well, who invited him?
I'm hitting quad row twist again, revisiting that. Love that poly first time around. Just looking forward to getting some more time on court with that one. A super spin friendly poly, pockets the ball nicely, spits it out with a ton of spins. That's always a good one. And then there's a new prototype string from Babala, which has been floating around, and we've got a message board playtest going to happen for that one. So I've got that in my racket too. I forget the code name for LT something or other, I think. It was written on the packet, but then the packet got thrown away when it got strung. But anyway, it is going to be part of a very popular Babala string family used by a very successful player who usually wins the French Open, but unfortunately for some this year. So it's going to be part of that string family.
I'm on a team? No, I'm just kidding.
And I've been hitting that one. It's playing well in my racket, which is an 18-20. And I think some people have been having different experiences in more open string pattern rackets because there's some string movement issues happening with that one. But anyway, been playtesting that one a ton too.
Britt, I'm going to jump over to you. I saw some pink strings in your E-Zone 100. I know that's one of your favorites. Still your go-to, I'm guessing.
So actually, this is my normal go-to is Vocal Cyclone. But this is actually Kirschbaum Flash.
Oh, nice.
Which is actually kind of my string I've been enjoying right now. Comes in lots of colors, which is always fun for me. But it does everything really well for me. I feel like as I'm continuing to get my footing and my timing back, it's offered me enough control and spin there. Really complements this E zone for me. Even if I'm miss hitting, where I'm going is in that right direction. So I've been enjoying this one. I'm going to continue, but I always, if I had to go play a tournament right now, I'd still go back to Vocal Cyclone. But I think this one's 17 gauge that I liked.
Jay, what about you? I think you're going to take mine. Yeah.
Yeah. I actually have a bunch of strings that are string guru Jonathan has given me, but I haven't strung them up yet. But so far, I've just been going back to the Lynx Tour. It's just so nice. Great feel. Lots of spin. You too. And like we have opposite games, like lots of spin, flat, but it still works for both.
Yeah, I love that string. It's awesome. Yeah. Also have to give a shout out to Hyper G whatever. All of the Hyper G's are allowed to come play with the Playtesters.
Definitely a Playtester favorite.
Yeah, for sure. We should talk tensions in case like anyone's maybe made a drastic change and like Chris is all of a sudden stringing at 56 pounds. In fact, someone yesterday on YouTube said that they had gotten, it was a pure drive, I think, and they were referencing the recommended tension, but then they were referencing what Chris had said about where he likes to string down in the 40s, and they were confused and didn't know what to do. So Chris, where's your tension at right now?
So I'll go, if it's a really stiff dead poly, I'll go like 48 pounds. And then if it's a livelier sort of multi, I'm at 52 pounds probably. And then I'll adjust from there. You know, if it's the first time out with the string and I have a couple of sets of it, I'll feel like I'm liking some things, but maybe there's something else I don't want to, you know, I want to add something. As I want to add more power and add more control, I'll adjust my attention. So I'll go tighter for more control, and then I'll go lower for more launch. So if you're not familiar with what the string bed is doing in a racket, basically the lower the tension you go, the less deformed the ball is going to get when it comes in. So it's going to retain more of its own energy. It's not going to pancake as much, as we say, go flat in the string bed. So a softer string, a lower tension, will let that ball just sit in there. It'll pocket it. And then you get this, what we call like a trampoline bounce back out. Whereas if it's a very stiff string or a very tight tension, the ball comes in, it loses a lot of its energy, it compresses and then just kind of flops out. So you can really take a big swing. That's the technical term.
That's a good word.
Yeah. you can take a huge swing with a stiffer string bed and the ball is more likely to stay in. And then if you're looking for a lot of spin, some players like that, because, you know, you can get a lot of racket speed, turn a fast swing into lots of spin. Conversely, some players like a lower tension for more spin because the ball sits on the strings nice and long and you can carry it through your swing and then throw it out with some spin. So different strokes for different folks. Plop.
Plop.
Plop. Remember that? Plop.
Plopped. Plop some knowledge. Okay, Britt, what's your tension at right now?
Well, Chris really gave a detailed answer. I feel like I continue to slowly drop. I think right now I'm really digging 52 pounds for whatever reason. Obviously, I'll adjust, like Chris said, if I feel I need it, but 52 pounds for my go-to tension. And I do, this is very sad, but I mentally like strings like a week after I string them. So
like a month, but yeah.
Okay. Let's but yes. I don't like to admit that, but yeah. At least a week in. So I'm sure the tensions probably drop more by the time I actually hit with it. But
Jay,
everyone like to let their racket sit for a little bit because there's a big difference hitting a racket fresh off the machine or just letting it sit overnight. Anyone want to talk about that?
No, I was just going to say, I string the tightest out of everyone. So if it's a really stiff string and I get it right off the stringer and I take it down to the court, I can tell right away that is a tight, stiff, low powered experience. I have to be in the right mood, but I don't always hate it. I actually don't mind it at all because I do prefer to like not feel anything from my string bed except like a board. And then it really allows you to hit out because again, it's very, very low powered experience. And then anyone that's ever experienced that and you kind of freak out and you're like, oh shoot, I obviously went 2 pounds too tight. You can simply put the racket on the ground and softly, softly kind of stretch out that string bed and it will open the strings up a little bit. And that should usually circumvent a tight string issue.
Or let it sit for a couple of days.
Or let it sit for a couple of days.
Yeah, I want to say like over like the weekend, like swing it up on a Friday and then I'll have it ready for Monday and it'll be good.
Sometimes around here, we get so excited about new rackets and like we have this whole process that when rackets come, we can't necessarily like just go and play with them. So it can be the anticipation builds. So it's like the second it gets off a stringer, sometimes if your timing is just right and you're about to go hit, it's like, yes, I get to hit this racket finally.
Yes.
And we've got that going on with a lot of stuff right now. So
actually just happened with some rackets.
Yeah, I know.
But yeah.
Jay, where are you at tension wise?
Between 50 and 52 is usually where I'm at. Yeah. Not much more to add to that. So yeah, I kind of like around 50, depending on the string stiffness, but right there.
And that's a good place to be. That's where we usually test most of our rackets. If we have more than one hitter, we're lucky enough that some of us can string it up differently than the main hitter. But yeah, we often seem to gravitate towards 52. It's a good middle ground for everyone. Cause well, I'm up there.
Yeah. So if like you and I are on a play test, you know, I'm like, wow, 48's good. And you're like, oh, 57's good.
Yeah.
We end up around, yeah, somewhere 52.
And then who knows sometimes what J-Dub gives us.
Yeah. Free stretch, constant pull.
He went around the world on it.
Yeah.
I'll like have a sticker that says attention. I'm like, there's no way that's right. But it's all good. He like will put a sticker and then tell the stringer to do something different. He's trying to get me mentally. It's fine. Overgrips. Let's like just keep digging into all the equipment. Does anyone have a particular overgrip that you're like obsessed with, can't play without? Oh, okay, Chris, let's go.
He's team dry, we're team tacky.
So I hit this a couple of times and then I re-hit it when Britt and I were actually doing an E-zone shoot out on the clay courts, Shell Beach. And we had to grip a racket up for the shoot. And then I was like, oh, it's nice to get a dry grip back on my racket. And man, I really love the feel of that racket. It's not super dry and harsh feeling on your hands. So if you're kind of not hitting it a lot, you know, you can go into it without getting blisters and stuff, which some of the really dry grips I find I have had that issue with in the past. So it's got a really nice soft feel to it and it absorbs really, really well. So dynamite grip. If you haven't tried it, highly recommend it. Even if you don't play in a super humid area, it's a very comfortable grip to have on. So,
Britt, do you have a favorite grip?
I'm the weird one that I actually prefer not to have an overgrip. The smaller, the better grip for me. So I typically just use the grip that's on there. And if we're playtesting, so I'm always the one that's taking the grips off. So people will be like, what happened to the overgrip? I took it off.
That's okay.
Yeah, it's your Tiffany.
Yeah, I was going to say Tiff too, though.
I actually do that sometimes too. I like a smaller
hand. Okay, good. See, it's not just me. But yes, I prefer no overgrip. I was like, I guess if I had to choose, I would do just like the Wilson Pro overgrip, the standard.
Have you tried the Yonex dry grip?
I have. On that shoot, I also regrip my racket.
There's a sales pitch in here. But wait. Jason, what overgrips your go-to?
I'm opposite of Chris once again, and I like the tacky, not the dry stuff. So I like Wilson Pro or Yonex Super Grap are my go-tos. I think the Wilson Pro is not as tacky, and a little bit thinner. The super grab kind of provides you a little bit more tack. It's thicker. They both actually last pretty decently long, at least for me. I don't change them out too often. So yeah, those are my two go-tos.
Yeah, another vote for Wilson Pro. No complaints. It's like, why change something that works? It's so good. It's consistent. I've used it like forever and ever. Yeah. So no switching for me on that one. I know there's some competitors to it, but it remains top of the game, in my opinion. Let's see. How about some shoes? Let's talk shoes. Maybe we can reveal some of the shoes that we're playtesting. They maybe will have launched by the time this episode launches also. But we have noticed, I think it's worth noting, we have seen some slow production issues from vendors getting their shoes to us in the United States. You're seeing this across the tennis industry. It's not just Tennis Warehouse. So it's been a little bit of a slow first half of the year for shoes, but I think we've got a strong second half. So Chris, what's your current go-to? And is there anything that you've play tested recently or that might be coming out that you can talk about that you're really excited about in terms of footwear?
So a shoe I look forward to play testing. And then when I play tested it, enjoyed it even more than I thought I was going to. And I'm on my second pair of them. And that's K-Swiss Jot 3.
Nice.
Love this shoe. Super comfortable. This is how I take my shoes on and off, by the way. I lace them once.
You and Troy.
Slide in and out. I've got skinny feet. But yeah, I really enjoy this shoe. Good cushioning, supports my feet really well. Yeah, does everything. We were on quite a few players on tour rocking that one too. So I'm not the only one out there singing praises.
Nice.
Yeah, that's a top three shoe for me.
What else is in there?
My current shoe of choice is.
Best
shoe ever. Mine isn't actually signed by Novak like this one is.
Dang.
But I've been using that shoe for 6-7-8 months now, and it's like I love that shoe. I always go back to it. It has just like that perfect combination of like it's supportive but I still feel quick in it. I love the traction on it. You can slide out in it easily. Super stable and supportive. So that's been my go-to for months now. And then we're actually currently playtesting this. I don't know if I can show it.
By the time this comes out, you can show.
If you pause real quick, I'm sure someone will see it.
It is the New Balance Lob.
Long two. Up. Yeah, two. Two.
Yeah, two. And the other one was the code FF2.
Yes, in case you're not watching. Yeah, they're going to be like, maybe
they're like, wait, what did he just show?
Long awaited update, I feel like.
I think universally, we love that shoe. It was like such a comfortable New Balance shoe, at least on the men's side. On the men's side, I think we all enjoyed it.
Have you hidden this one yet?
This one? No, I just got it. Okay. So have you?
Yeah, there's a long break in.
Oh.
But I think it's super stable. It's very stiff. And I think it's going to be really durable too. I've hidden it like five times now. And still waiting for it to break in. But I think it's going to last a long time once it finally breaks in.
Okay. I agree. Concur.
You've hit it too as well?
Yeah. And yeah. I struggled with the break in my second wear. But the heel counter is so like it locks your heel in. You're locked in that shoe. But it is, yeah, definitely. If you guys have played in the NXT from Nike and you thought that had a break in, this one has a longer break in.
I was going to say that one. That one took me a while. It might be not broken in.
I like that shoe a lot.
I do too. Yeah,
I really like that one.
Actually, and I haven't forgotten about you, but I wanted to bring up two controversial shoes. One is the A6 Gel Resolution 8 because people...
What's the controversy?
Thank you. I love it. I think most of the playtesters love it, would put it as an easy top five shoe. And some people just don't like it, and they think there's some conspiracy that we, I don't know, but we all love it. I wore them over the weekend.
They're Jerez 8?
Yeah.
What's the beef?
I love that shoe. It's dynamite.
Yeah. Well, I mean, what's
the dino wall to go with this dynamiteness?
Dino wall. Yeah. So I just kind of wanted to clear the air because we have had customers complain that it is not a good shoe, but it's stable. And like, if Jason likes it and Chris likes it, he's got wide feet, he's got skinny feet, it works. It's durable, it's stable. The colors are popping, like the kids would say, or they wouldn't.
I mean, I think it's a really comfortable shoe. You know, I didn't take me a huge break in on that one at all. Uppers flex and move with my feet nicely. Yeah, I feel fast in it for a stable, durable shoe. It feels fast out there on the court.
Okay.
The one thing with Asics shoes is they're noisy. The outsoles squeak a lot.
Yeah, they squeak. They're loud.
Hard court, but yeah, it's my only knock on it, really.
And then the other controversial one I was going to bring up is the Nike React Vapor Next or NXT. Same as Chris. I actually really like that shoe. I find it to be very stable. And a lot of people don't like it.
I think one thing to consider is, like, when we play test anything, it's for a month. I mean, we hit Racquets for a month. I mean, it takes a while for us to get our reviews done because we put the hours in, and we, same with strings, same with shoes. And if you go out and hit in a shoe for 30 minutes and then think you can comment on it, you really can't, because the shoe's going to change every time you play in it. It's going to continue to mold to the shape of your foot throughout its life until you... And we will put holes in shoes. You know, sometimes shoes don't last a month. And some of the playtesters are harder on the outsoles or uppers, and et cetera. But yeah, the Vapor, React Vapor Next, NXT, it takes a break in. Once you get through that, that's a good shoe. I wish it locked in around the ankle a little better. The lace system, it's kind of connected to the inner booty and not the upper. There, it's just got this like loop. And if I felt like if they drilled a hole through all of that and put a grommet in and connected it, I would get a little bit more cinched in feel right around the ankle collar. But yeah, I do like that shoe.
Britt, what's your current go-to shoe?
Well, your thing kind of segued into it, but I've been wearing a ton of running shoes lately. So I hadn't really worn tennis shoes. And so getting back on the courts, for some reason I instantly have been really... going back to the GP Turbo, which is like super plush cushioning. I'd call it like a really good, like teaching pros, I feel like would really love it. Like it just, I felt like it was like a nice in between, between my like running shoes that like had like Adidas Boost or something. And then I also, the K-Swiss Hypercourt Supreme, the Marco shoe. That's another go-to, and the Gelres 8. So those are the three I've kind of been rotating out. A little bit more support, stability, and cushioning. I'm normally a more lighter weight shoe fan, but coming back in, I'm going that way for a little bit, at least until I'm fully back in action. But yeah, no, the cushioned, supportive, stable shoes. I did get to hit with I feel like I'm out of the loop on the Nike shoes, but I did get to hit the Ubersonics 4 too, which were like a nice lightweight. I felt low to the ground. Good cushioning on the heel. I could probably use a little bit more cushioning in the forefoot. And I don't know if it was similar to the Nike, the Vapor NXT, but I couldn't quite get locked in on the ankle. I don't know if it was as similar with the booty construction, but.
Yeah, I think that's a similar vibe actually between those two. It's like a really supportive upper, but you could use like one more eyelet to like really cinch up. Yeah.
I don't know if I just had skinny ankles or
that too. You and Chris have that problem.
I also, if you notice, take off my shoes like that too. Skinny feet club.
Oh, that's funny. So I do that sometimes with shoes, and like it bugs me so much because then when I go to put them on, I have to unlace them. Or you guys don't have to do that. No. Okay. Never mind.
Every once in a while, this shoe comes along, and I'm like, you mean I have to lace this thing every time I'm going to put it on?
I might have to like retighten the lace, but no.
Yeah, every once in a while.
Okay. Okay. Well, let's do a quick like bag check. What's your favorite bag at the moment? I know this is always like my expertise area. I know I can walk you guys through some new bags, but does anyone have a bag that they love or would recommend to someone or anything new, or even if it's old, tried and true?
Hey, this bag is a little pricey, but that Lacoste bag is sick. It's like a sweet bag. I use the Technofiber rack pack, I'm guessing it's called, whatever. The newer white one. Love that bag. The Lacoste one is very, very similar to that, but I feel like everything just got kicked up a notch. And that's saying something, because the Technofiber bags are like insane quality. And the Lacoste one just feels even more special.
Yeah. And we got a preview of some new Technofiber bags coming in. And I feel like they literally designed a bag based off of Chris's like day-to-day work bag. So there's a cool bag coming for tennis, which is cool. I said cool too many times. Britt, what about you?
Well, Chris beat me to it. That was like the first thing popped up into my head was the Lacoste bag.
Yeah, Chris beat me to it too. I was
maybe hopefully down the road they'll do like a cool backpack or tote or something, because I could use that as my an upgrade to my one right now. But also I use obviously the Yonex E-Zone. So right before I went on maternity leave, I think I upgraded to, it was like an all black one that looked really cool. So it's stored all my stuff for those couple months.
Perfect.
Quite efficiently.
Jay, I think you're the winner of that You won the Lacoste bag.
I did. I was lucky that I got to take the, you guys had bags, so I got to take that Lacoste one. So I was going to say that one, because it is. I didn't want to sound too bougie. But I that's an awesome bag.
Yeah.
It was really nice.
I have to give a shout out to the Coco Golf line of bags from Head. I would carry one day to day as my gym bag, and it's really cool because it's like that neoprene scuba material almost.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And it's like black with hits of pink, so it's kind of low key, not too like in your face, but still kind of feels trendy. And then, of course, so to the court, I'm always carrying the Tita rack pack, allegedly. Can we call it that? The T-Dub duffel. I have been filling that thing way too full. I need to empty it or clean it out one of these days, but it literally carries everything. So
that one's really nice. And then the new racket bag too. I have one of the samples when we were kind of going through, you know, different changes and logos and just checking materials and stuff. So I have one of the early samples of that back at the house. And that's a really nice bag as well, just the racket bag, if you want more of a, you know, traditional silhouette.
Yeah, and low-key plug, any day now, actually probably 2 weeks out from today, we should have new Tennis Warehouse backpacks on the website, which will be a more durable, more functional option than our current backpack. So a little more...
more premium?
Techie. A little more premium, yeah. A little more specific with everything. There's some good pockets for shoes, rackets, obviously, tons of gear. Booney carries one on a day-to-day basis. So I'm excited. Hopefully those get out.
Does he think it's better than good?
It's better than good.
Like peanut butter and chocolate.
Oh, he had a really good one yesterday, and I can't remember. Stay tuned for the episode with Boonies, Boonieisms. Favorite, like current favorite, like accessory or item, anything else that we have that you want? That
I've got something.
Oh, what?
I went first and stole the thunder on the. I'll go last this time.
Okay, Bray, I'll let you go.
Oh, okay. I was gonna go with the new T-Dub hat.
I was gonna say the whole hat decline. I'm not even wearing the cool one.
I know. I can't remember, but I got the like the maroon colored one, and it's really nice.
Is it the 87 or the 47?
47.
It's like
the 47
actual
brand.
It's an actual hat style. Yeah.
Yeah, but yeah, it's nice because it's like it's an off court, but it has enough performance that I can wear it on court too.
It's super trendy. It's like on point in style. And then like, it's also very easy to cross over men, women, kid, dog. Anyone can wear it.
Yeah.
Jay, what about you? Favorite item of the moment?
It's probably going to be what Chris is currently wearing as his shirt.
Oh, I know. He is wearing, so is Boonie today. I was like, yeah.
The new T-Dub California shirt. Awesome. And you don't have to be from California to rock this shirt. It's just a cool looking shirt.
Right?
And Tennis Warehouse was founded in California anyway, yeah. So.
Yeah.
So it's a shout out to our roots.
And it's $10 and it's super soft tee. It's awesome.
I got it from my dad for Father's Day. So
cute. I love that.
What was yours, Chris? Was it going to be your shirt?
Well, no.
Or the hat.
Did I take it finally?
No, you didn't.
Ha-ha. Oh, wait. I feel like I've got one. Oh.
Oh.
Where did that come from?
Just because Michelle is such a huge fan of vintage rackets.
Where did your wood come from?
Right? Just pulled it right out. So this is a bankrupt super winner. This is currently my favorite Woody to play with. But we got a great selection of wood.
So yeah, we do.
Go to check out Vintage Racquet Page. I had to prep it because I have it. I keep mine in a press, which I found. We don't have those for sale, but we do have always a good selection of wood. Check the vlog. Vlog for the vlog. Yeah, bringing you vintage wood. We scour the earth to find these things. Sometimes they find us, but we always seem to find new old stock vintage cool rackets. So
yeah, and if you're watching the vlog and there's a racket that you want and you cannot find it, it's because it's sold out. Those things go fast.
They do, yeah. Sometimes we only have like one, you know, maybe two, but quite often we just have singles, so yeah, they go quickly.
I was gonna add a quick accessory as well. I actually thought Chris was gonna take mine. Therabody Theraguns. I have the mini. Yeah, I had taken a hiatus from Theragunning. Don't ask me why. My body obviously could use it. But last night I was like, shoot, I was feeling some stiffness and soreness all over. So that mini is like perfect. You plug it in, get it all charged up, and then use it for, you know, if you go back and check out the podcast with Dr. J, the founder, I think a lot of people think that you should be Theragunning for like a half hour, and that's not the case, to be honest. So really cool to like learn a little bit more about best practices for those devices.
One thing I really like about the Theragun, which I didn't realize, was to use them for warming up.
Same, right?
Yeah. Get your muscles feeling super loose and ready to go out and play.
Britt's like,
I need it right now.
Yeah, it was really cool. And like she's got her own Theragun. You like just basically kind of trace. Yeah. Anyways, you can go back and listen. He gives a full in-depth discussion on how to use it as a warm-up tool, but it's a good accessory. And if you have a massive tennis bag, like some of us do, it will fit. Cool. Anything else? Any last minute secrets we can talk about in terms of anything that's coming that we're allowed to spill the beans on? We're pretty tight-lipped on things right now.
I was going to say it's lots of stuff coming heavy next, or heavy starting really like end of July, August around US Open. Almost all brands will have something going on, racket brands. And then I know shoes, we've been getting some playtest samples in. So yeah, nothing specific.
Nothing.
Check back in a couple weeks.
We'll do some good episodes on beyond the playtest and all of that on some of the new stuff coming out, I think, because we've got some exciting things to talk about. Any bold predictions for Wimbledon? I don't know if this will come out before or after, but
Rafa won't win it.
Rafa's not going to win it.
No Rafa, sorry. Neither will Osaka, sorry.
I mean, Berrettini's looking good. Rublev's looking good.
Djokovic is looking good.
I think Djokovic might get all four Grand Slams this year. Don't know about Olympics as well, but I think, I mean, what an epic achievement if he did it. But I think he's looking tough to beat, you know? So, yeah, I think he could do it. I don't want to put the Edwards curse on him.
It is real and it is strong.
But I think he could, yeah, I think he could do it.
Well, you heard it here first, although a lot of people are talking about it.
I'm not the first one to mention this.
Cool. Well, thank you guys for joining. We will link to all these products and everything else. If you guys have any further questions, you can always reach out and email us, and stay tuned for the second part of our playtester picks, while where some of the other playtesters join and talk about what they're currently using. So thanks for joining and thanks for listening. And until next time, happy hitting. Woo!